This is the growth of China's high-speed rail network, which started in 2008 and continues until today, reaching a length of more than 30,000 kilometers in 2019, making China's high-speed rail the biggest one in the world. Spain, which has the world's second biggest high-speed rail network, has around 3,100 kilometers of track in operation, followed by Japan, Germany, and France. The Chinese plan to complete 38,000 kilometers of high-speed rail in 2025 and 45,000 kilometers until 2030, making it longer than the Earth's equator, which is only around 40,000 kilometers long. But not only the size of the high-speed rail network increased, with it, the speeds at which the bullet trains operate increased too, including China's first maglev that connects Shanghai with the Pudong International Airport, a distance of 30 kilometers, taking 8 minutes in all. It is the one and only commercially operating maglev train in the world, and also the fastest, with a speed of 430 kilometers per hour. On the 21st of April in 2015, a new record was set by floating with a speed of 603 kilometers per hour. The SC Maglev L0 series was developed by the Central Japan Railway Company. SC stands for superconducting. This cutting-edge technology is unique to Japan. In 1962, research into developing Japan's own maglev technology began. Since then, engineers and scientists have worked on the topic. Currently, the superconducting maglev is tested on a 42.8-kilometer long Yamanashi test track near the beautiful Mount Fuji. It will cover a distance of 286 kilometers between Tokyo and Nagoya by 2027 and link the two biggest cities of Japan, Osaka and Tokyo, by 2045, which corresponds to 410 kilometers. At the beginning, passengers will travel at a speed of 500 kilometers per hour, cutting traveling time from now 2 hours and 25 minutes to only 67. But how does it work? The SC Maglev is all about making possible higher speeds by eliminating friction to the rail and levitating by using strong superconducting magnets. The term maglev does not only refer to the train, but to the railway system as well. To fully understand the working principle of the SC Maglev, three fundamental concepts must be understood: electromagnetic induction, Lenz's law, and superconductivity. In order to work, the SC Maglev uses a principle called inductive power collection. Electricity in form of alternating current is provided by a substation near the maglev line. The current is fed to the ground coils under the train, inducing currents in the power collection coils of the rolling stock. This method of transferring power is based on the physical law of electromagnetic induction. Whenever an alternating current is flowing through a primary coil, a magnetic field is generated according to the current's direction. If a second coil is positioned near the alternating magnetic field, an electric field is induced, creating an electrical current to counter the magnetic fields of the primary coil. The phenomena of inducing a magnetic field with an opposite polarity is called Lenz's law and will be crucial in the following. The received energy is used for the superconducting magnets and its cooling system. Both are placed in the boogie. The cooling system consists of liquid helium and cheaper liquid nitrogen. The superconductive magnet is a coil made from niobium, titanium, and copper. While copper adds mechanical stability to the coil winding, niobium titanium, a type 2 superconductor with critical temperature of 10 Kelvin, is responsible for generating the strong magnetic fields with a maximum of 15 Tesla. In the Japanese maglev, the superconductor is cooled down to a working temperature of 4.15 Kelvin. In this state, its electrical resistance becomes zero, thus losing little to no energy. propulsion, levitation, as well as guidance are achieved with two additional types of coils in the sidewalls of the guideway. Alternating current is provided from the near substation to the propulsion coils. As a result, generating magnetic fields, same poles repel each other, whereas different polarities feel an attractive force. Only if the train's position and velocity is synchronized with the substation, perfect propulsion can be achieved. Moreover, speed is controlled through a variation of the frequency at which the magnetic fields change. By picking up pace, the superconducting magnets first induce currents that run through the lower part of the figure-8-shaped levitation coil, causing a repelling magnetic force according to Lenz's law. Because of the coil's geometry, a second magnetic field is generating, thus attracting the magnets of the rolling stock and letting it levitate up to 10 cm above the guideway. Levitation of the superconducting maglev does not require any additional energy, and in case of power loss, it will continue to levitate as long as it remains at high speeds. Slowing down decreases the induced force, bringing the maglev safely down on its rubber wheels. Let's have a look at the third function, guidance. Like levitation, it does not require any additional energy. If the maglev moves from the center to one of the sides of the guideway, the sudden increase of magnetic fields on one side generates a magnetic field with reverse polarity, therefore opposing and repelling the superconducting magnets. The same happens on the other side. A weakening magnetic field creates a force that brings the maglev back to the center in all circumstances. The higher its velocity, the more stable the levitating system becomes. In February 2017, the Japanese superconducting maglev completed all technological developments necessary for revenue service and was confirmed for exporting. Overall, the maglev system is very safe. Operating fully autonomous, it can handle almost any weather, and also, because of levitation, even earthquakes. It features three different types of braking systems: regenerative braking, aerodynamic braking for emergencies, and conventional disc braking, therefore showing a better deceleration performance compared to other bullet trains. In addition, it offers a fast, convenient, as well as more efficient alternative to short or medium haul flights. Normal bullet trains or airplanes at same speed consume far more energy than the superconducting maglev. But there's a hitch. The Chuo Shinkansen is unbelievably expensive, in all costing around $83 billion. The Tokaido Shinkansen, currently connecting Tokyo with Osaka, had a cost of just $8 billion. The main reason for that is the construction of completely new infrastructure, including guideways, coils, but new bridges and tunnels too, which as a result generates thousands of jobs in industries like steel, logistics, and engineering in a short period of time. Maintenance costs will be low, giving countries like China and the US the chance to improve air quality by reducing highway congestion and relieving air travel, problems that cost billions of dollars each year. Meanwhile, China revealed its own maglev prototype, capable of traveling with 600 km per hour, ready for commercial production in 2021. Ongoing Chinese research focuses on eliminating air resistance, as a result making possible hyperloop speeds of 1000 km per hour. But whereas this technology is in its research phase, real maglev systems like the L0 series represent proven technology. The Shanghai and superconducting maglev are only the beginning of ultra-high-speed rail, expected to have a far-reaching impact, improving economical productivity and people's life in the long term. Maglevs are the next step, filling the gap between bullet trains and airplanes, maybe becoming even faster in future. They have the potential to change a lot, and that is what makes them so fascinating. Thank you for watching. Stay curious.